Vazi World by Mark Battles. Mark Anthony Battles was born in Indianapolis, Indiana. His family had it bad coming up living in multiple homeless shelters, but things started to turn around while he was in high school. He was inspired by Tupac, Eminem, Drake, and Big Pun, to name a few. He started rapping when he was 15 years old. 2 years after graduating, he started his own label called Fly America. He would recruit other artists as well as drop projects. In 2017, he announced a deal with Coach K and Quality Control Music. Vazi World is his second project of that deal, but Battles has over 25 projects. How do we feel about Vazi World?
Vazi World, man. Victory against society's ignorances.
All right.
Very dope name.
Yeah.
All right, man. Not super familiar with Mark Battles. There's a couple. I got to get that out of the way first.
Right.
Heard him before, but haven't actually progressed to listen to anything else he's put out. Back On came on, and I was like, cool.
Yeah.
Came on. He came in with some bars. I liked the sample that they used in the beginning.
It was real dope.
That was pretty dope. Can't Tell Me was cool. All was one of those songs that I actually like. You know what I'm saying? Here We Go Again with Futuristic and Jaron Benton. Yo, Jaron Benton be sounding like B.O.B. sometimes.
Yeah,
I thought it was B.O.B., bro. But yeah, I actually liked that song. It was really dope. The Moon was cool. Lord Knows was probably one of the more likable songs for me. Gretzky is okay. I'm not sure about Brittany Janae as far as the singer goes. At least on this song. She was a lot better on the song from Day 2. But Gretzky, the other thing about Gretzky is, yeah, he has some bars in there. I gotta say that first and foremost. Yeah, he has bars in that song. But it's the topic, like, the hook doesn't go along with the lyrics.
Right.
It was like, you know, it was throwing me off. 12-15, he was actually pretty cool on most of the songs that he was on.
Right.
Fourth and Inches was okay, but I actually liked the last three songs. I thought he kind of tried to, you know, jam it in at the last stretch on everything, Mad and Imagine. I do want to say that I don't feel like the energy on this project was kind of low. And I felt like that affected how I felt about the music because, like I said, it's obvious that he has dope lyrical ability. He has dope lyricism. He has dope punchlines, bars, and everything like that. But the energy he's putting forth on this project is just different. And even on Day 2, like, it sounded as if he was depressed for the most part.
Yeah.
But I know that stuff usually brings out a lot of good music and a lot of people. And I felt like on this project, I didn't necessarily get that. You know what I'm saying? So, when I didn't get that, I was just like, I want to make sure I've heard something else to at least compare it to. So that's when I went and listened to Day 2. And
I
actually like Day 2 a lot more than I like this. The energy is a lot better. The beat selection is a lot better. I feel like he just has to pick better beats. I do feel like he's a good, different artist for Quantity Control. I will not call them Quality Control because, man, they don't know how to keep the number of tracks down. Because this is his second project in like 2-3 months.
Okay.
I mean, it's cool, but I just feel like he has to keep the energy consistent. He has to pick better beats.
I agree.
I like the way he direction he's going with his artists and with his movement and everything. All of that stuff is cool. So I hope he keeps it up. Don't want anybody to stop working. You know, but I give it a C-. Thought it was average.
What? Bro, what are you talking about?
Yeah, man. You know, when Back On came on, I thought I was like, okay. Start rolling. Can't Tell Me was straight. All was like, all right. Here We Go Again was real hot, but I did not like the chorus. Like that. Here We Go Again.
Yeah, I didn't care for it either.
I wasn't feeling that. But, you know, I love everybody. I thought they, you know, brought it to the track. Futuristic was really dope. The Moon and Lord Knows I thought was really cool. 12-15 did shine on this project. I thought it was pretty cool. Even though he was a frequent collaborator on this, I was just like, you know, it was nice to hear him. Gretzky was all right. Fourth and Inches, I liked the beat and where it took it. And On Everything was all right. I guess that was the lead single to this project. So it was straight. Mad, I thought he could have went a little bit harder on. Because just the feeling I got through this whole project was like, you know, he was kind of holding back. I don't know about his other projects or anything, but I listened to Day 2, and he sounded more aggressive a little bit. Even though you say he sounded kind of depressed and everything like that, it sounded like he had more of a hunger on that project to me. And Imagine was a cool way to go out. It was a little soft for me, but other than that, you know, he does have some lyrical ability and everything, but he doesn't keep me in tune. He doesn't keep me hooked on what he's saying, and it kind of gets me a little bored. But I would say that he's a good fit for Quantity Control, because I believe he brings another element that they don't have, and that's just the type of energy that he has. So, you know, it kind of brings him to stand out in that label, as opposed to, you know, Lil Yachty, Quavo, and all of them, you know. So I thought in that, right, it was decent. But, you know, as far as this project goes, you can consider it as an EP, even though it's 11 tracks, but I gave it a C-. You know, no. It just didn't really hit me there, but I see the promise, but it's got a little bit to go there. And I don't know how all the other projects sound, so I know there's a lot that I don't know about, but as far as for this project, I wasn't feeling it that much.
Yeah, man, and instead, I mean, don't get me wrong, you can hit the comments up, tell us how trash we are, how stupid we are. That don't bother me. But what would actually be more doper is if you would actually tell us some songs from him him to actually go check out.
Right, right.
You know, I'm not changing my Dave East review. I'm sorry. Fuck all y'all. Shit. Yo, you looking for TV reviews, music reviews, movie reviews? Then check out the only reviews that matter, man.
Yeah, just hit that subscribe button. Make sure you hit the notifications and stay tuned.